I please invite on screen Mr. Anand Bhadkamkar, CEO Denso International India, to share with us the summary of the report. A very warm welcome to you.
Hi, good afternoon, and a pleasure to be here, and welcome to this fifth edition of Denso Exchange for Media Digital Advertising Report. I'll just bring my screen on, just give me a sec. I hope it doesn't, perfect. So as I said, this is the fifth edition of Denso Exchange for Media Digital Advertising Report. And what we intend to do today is I'll just walk you through in general, just a brief overview, and then Abhik, my colleague, he'll join us in presenting the entire summary of this report. Walk us through that. After that, we have an excellent array of speakers and panelists which are lined up for sharing the thoughts on the current digital innovations that are happening now the market is evolving. So a long sort of entertaining time as well after that. Back to the report. As I said, this is a fifth edition. When we started this journey along with Exchange for Media around 5 years back, the idea at that point of time for the report was in the market, there was a sort of lack of information or availability of robust data around digital advertising. While digital has always been the fastest growing segment in the advertising industry, and as you would see in the report when you go through that, even during the pandemic period, digital has continued to be the fastest growing and will continue to do so. And so there was this opportunity, and there was a need, or a sort of a burning need at that point of time, that we need to get a credible and accurate reporting out in the market. That's what we did in our partnership with Exchange for Media. And this is the fifth year. And it's really pleasing that this Denso digital report has become like a sort of most credible and accurate source of reporting within the media industry. And it gets quoted at multiple industry forums as well. So that's one pleasing thing. Back at Denso, we have been partnering with our clients over the period for getting business outcomes or providing solutions to their business problems. And there's a strong team of more than 3,000 advertising professionals in Denso, Denso India, of which almost 2,000 are digital professionals, where we work with the clients in providing them help on their digital transformation journeys and as we move along. So that's where Denso is at present while working with the clients. And as we move along, we'll just keep on driving the thing. As Anurag also mentioned, 2020 has been in a way actually unique and one of the most challenging years. Means most of us, or I would say all of us, have never seen such a event. The pandemic, it impacted us all throughout. Means it was be it professional, be it at your business, be it at economy, globally, at markets. And the larger thing of that was it impacted us socially as well. It was a socio-economic sort of a challenge or catastrophe. And what that did was that impacted us the way we transact, the way we work, the way we interact with each other as well. And that has had a deepening impact on the consumer behavior. So 2020 saw a large shift. As you would go through the report as well, you'll get some more insights as you start going through that. There have been quite insightful messaging within that. The consumer behavior also changed, and I think that's changed for generations to come. And what that did was actually, even Anurag alluded to that, the digital transformation sort of accelerated. It was at personal levels. We started consuming more entertainment, education, the kids' educations that came home, the schools are shut down. So it went online, entertainment just increased. And a larger impact, which was for businesses, was the transition to e-commerce or using the digital platforms for transacting or interacting. And that has made a big difference in the way we are operating as businesses, as brands, as consumers. The physical connect moved away because of pandemic, the social distancing became the norm. And in that, digital is the one which has become one of the, I would say, gainers, or where the transition has happened. And that's where more and more focus of people, businesses, and the entire community is moving towards. How do we interact? How do we create more experiences for our teams and we move forward? Come 2021, there are positive offshoots. Means in the digital transformation journey which started last year, the brands have started coming a long way when we have started moving in that direction. But 2021, there are a lot of positive when I speak specifically of India. Well, globally, the pandemic still goes on in Americas or in Europe. It's still going ahead. Fortunately for India, our COVID cases have come down drastically. Our peak hopefully has been completed in September. So there's a positivity around that. Vaccines have been started now. So 2021 looks promising. 2021 obviously is testimony to the resilience of we as a country, as a community, for getting across this pandemic. And economy-wise, India seems to be on a good trajectory. IMF is calling out that we might be growing at 11.5%. Even the budget which the finance minister presented, there are a lot of positives coming out of that. So 2021 definitely is looking at a much positive space as far as India is concerned. And you'll see in the digital report as well that overall as advertising, the numbers are expected to grow. We expect the advertising spends to grow by around 10.8%, 11% in 2021. While in 2020, we had a huge hit as an industry, almost 18% spends dropped. So getting back to that 2019 level for us, it's going to be around a year more. But 2021 definitely has a lot many positives to come out of for 2020. And I think that's where we are moving towards as a country, as advertising industry, as marketeers and as brands to be more socially relevant for our consumers, or to be more socially relevant and purpose-driven when we engage with the consumers. And that digital transformation journey is going to be something which is going to be critical or the driving force as we get on to our subsequent journeys on this 2021 and beyond. So before I ask Abhik to take us more in detail on numbers, actually, how the numbers are looking like, how 2020 was, how 2021 is looking like as we move forward. But what definitely remains at core as we are seeing the transition happening, or brands getting more digital, we starting to interact onto the digital platforms with each other. Three V's which we had called out earlier, they still remain to be the key drivers. That is voice, video, and vernacular. We are seeing on digital platforms where the video content is being consumed, the regional is getting more and more prominence as well. Earlier, we had TikTok or other social media platforms. They have become quite important. What pandemic has done is actually, and the digital transformation, which got transformed or sort of which got much more push in India, was expansion of the digital adoption or a faster adoption of digital in our tier two and tier three cities. And that has largely contributed to this growth as well in 2020 and 2021. What that has helped do is digital has become the second largest medium in the country. TV remains the largest. Digital has overtaken print, which we had anticipated might be 2 years or 3 years down the line, but that has fast tracked. And digital is growing much faster than the rest of the mediums. Last year, all other mediums in 2020 had a degrowth, whereas digital grew by almost 17%, 15% over the previous period. So I think digital has kept that edge over the others, and it's part of the life cycle as we are moving forward. As I said earlier, the shift in consumer behavior, which has happened during 2020, and it has become a bit of a permanent shift as well. There are some interesting insights you'll go through when you get access to the report and you go through that. Some of that Abhik will walk us through. But similarly, what's coming in is actually what the digital transformation has done is the adoption of e-commerce or getting onto the commerce platforms. And especially in tier two, tier three cities, what has helped is actually the online retail, or even within metros, the Kirana stores, they have gone onto digital big time, your WhatsApps or social media for using of commerce. I think that's something which got increased. The focus now is more on how do you create those customer experiences? How do you engage much better with the consumer? And you start trading and retailing more from there. Similarly, 2020 saw adoption of digital by seniors, that is the elderly population. It was much different change in the current year. People shifted from cash payments to online payments or e-wallets, your payment wallets, they got a huge boost. That entire transaction shifted. And what that has done over the period is mobile has become sort of a part of its quasi digital, and mobile has almost taken over almost 75% of the digital spends, as you see happening for advertising purposes. So that's one huge shift which happened. Anurag also did mention that mobile has become part of our life, or the screens, multi-screen, and that's what is happening, and that's what will keep on happening as we move forward as well. But that's where we are at present. I'll ask Abhik to walk us through on the summary of the report. But while doing that, I just want to thank the Exchange for Media team, all our partners as well, for supporting us and for working with us and getting this report out. as well as the entire team at Dentsu who has worked on getting this report out, the details which you'll see. It's a very detailed report and it sort of talks through how the trends are coming up in digital as we move forward. So I hope you'll enjoy that report, and equally thanks to our speakers and panelists who are coming subsequently, because that's what is going to make this afternoon and evening entertaining. And hope you do enjoy going through the report. And if there's any feedback or any suggestions, we always feel welcome to share with us. I'll hand over to Abhik to walk us through some of the highlights of the report. Abhik?
Quest, Mr. Abhik Biswas, Associate Vice President, Consumer Insights, What Consult, to give us a detailed summary of the report, please. Welcome, Biswas.
Hey, hi. Hey, thank you, Anand, for introducing the report. And good afternoon, everyone. Well, there are many things that can very well describe the year 2020. Oxford Languages, in their annual Word of the Year, called 2020 unprecedented. And I believe it is fair to say that it very aptly describes this roller coaster sort of a year. Predictions were made, predictions failed, plans were made, plans changed. In this year, that advertising was expected to reach unseen heights, it stuck with unseen adversity. Many traditional advertising avenues, you know, were hit with economic downturns during this pandemic, and yet some benefited from it. For example, QR codes make a huge comeback in 2020. Unprecedented, right? And as the days of the pandemic continued to rise, the Indian advertising industry witnessed a degrowth of 17.5% compared to the previous year. It currently stands at 56,490 crore. But with the turn of this new decade, and the fortunes of the world of advertising are also expected to change, we as an industry will make a comeback, and the expected growth rate of that is going to be 10.8%. And by the end of this year, 2021, we are expected to reach a market size of 62,577 crores. Furthermore, the industry is expected to grow at a compound rate of 11.59% to reach 70,343 crores by 2022. With all eyes and hopes glued on us, who will be the catalyst of this comeback? Let's dive further into this. Currently, FMCG has the highest contribution to the Indian advertising market at 21%, closely followed by e-commerce at 17% and consumer durables at 10%. With the common man staying indoors for the better part of the year, we saw majority of the brands shift their focus from offline to online. E-commerce thrived this year, increasing its share from 10% in 2019 to 17% in 2020. FMCG's share nosedived from 30% last year to 21% in 2020. Looking at the pie of the advertising revenue, last year, the biggest contribution came from television screen. Thanks to its unparalleled reach, it contributed 41% to the advertising market. It is followed by digital at 28% and print coming in close at 25%. To think of it now, who would have put their money on digital over, you know, traditional media a decade ago? But from 2019 to 2020, digital increased its contribution share from 20% to 28% in just 1 year. While print saw a decline from 29% to 25%. Digital grew from strength to strength in this year, with its market size increasing from 13,683 crores in 2019 to 15,782 crores in 2020. A growth of 15.3% in a pandemic year. This makes it the only media platform to have seen such a positive growth, that too in double digits in a year. Now, looking at the future, digital is expected to grow at 20% to reach a market size of 18,938 crores by the end of 2021. And it will grow at a compound rate of 22.47% to reach a market size of 23,673 crores by the end of 2022. The most valued player of this growth of digital media was undoubtedly e-commerce, with its highest share contribution of 24%. Second in line is consumer durables with 17% contribution and FMCG at 14% contribution. Since 2019, e-commerce has increased its spend share on digital from 19% to 24% in 2020. Digital is going to see an unprecedented growth rate of 22.47% till 2022, and social media will be playing a huge part in this. Last year, it contributed 29% of its spend share on digital. But undoubtedly, and as Anand also mentioned, the year 2020 belongs to online video. From 22% contribution share to the digital, it increased to 28% in just 1 year. Paid search wasn't too far behind at 24%. The growth of digital in India year on year is a testament of how and at what rapid velocity is the consumer adapting and evolving this medium. And the biggest contributor of this medium, that what we have seen from our research, is not the main contribution is not coming from the locales of Bandra, but the streets of Banarasi. People belonging to tier 2 and tier 3 cities have gone digital in 2020, and how? Cashless payments, increased e-commerce purchase. And this adoption is not only being seen from the young Indian minds, but elder consumers are too showcasing a shift in purchase behavior, a trend never seen before. And this surge is not only limited to purchase, but also entertainment. The shift from India to Bharat accelerated in 2020 with the growth of regional and local language content. This was facilitated with an increased appetite of digital video consumption in these cities. And what it brought about, a much needed inclusivity in digital India. These footsteps were heard long back. The pandemic, you know, just fast-tracked the arrival of this inclusivity in digital and digitization of the country. E-commerce, OTT, Atmanirbhar Bharat, with its increased impetus on locally developed edtech, agritech, healthtech, fintech applications. These will be the three pillars of the growth of digital in the country. To think of it, if 2020 belonged to wearing a mask, 2021 is going to belong to making a mark. This is the DNA of marketing 2021. And all I can say is Jug Jug Jio.
Thank you so much, Abhik and Anand, for that wonderful detailed report.